Alright everybody, my name is Nick Rummel. I'm one of your, Hey everybody, my name is Nick Rummel. I'm one of your TAs, here for Scott, and, Hi, I'm Nick Rummel. I'm one of your TAs for Scott, and I have office hours in Stratton Hall from 4 to 6 p.m. On Tuesdays and Thursdays in Stratton Hall. That's my email, nrummel@mines.eu. If you have any questions for me, or if those office hours don't work for you, maybe we can meet outside of that. I'm always open to that. It's fine. If you have a problem, an initial value problem with the method of undetermined coefficients right here for you. First, we're going to be looking at a Y-homogeneous case. It's pretty simple this time because we see that if we move the equal sign, so this problem looks a little bit more familiar to you. We have dy dt equals negative y, which means we have a constant times e to the negative t. That's your homogeneous case. We have a y particular then, because there's a cosine, we also have to consider sine, so we have c2 cosine of 2t plus c3 sine of 2t. We're going to consider just the particular case for the moment, and we see that this equals negative y plus cosine of 2t. We substitute in, and we get 2c2 with a negative in front of it, sine of 2t, plus 2c3 cosine of 2t. This is your y prime term. Over here, we're going to get a negative c2 cosine of 2t minus c3 sine of 2t. And the reason for that being is we have this negative right here, and that's going to distribute into our y particular, which is this. So negative times y particular is negative c2 cosine of 2t minus c3 sine of 2t. And then we have this term still remaining, so we have a plus a cosine of 2t. And we now just look at like terms. We consider our sine terms first. And we have like terms. And we have our sine 2t terms. So we have negative c2 equals negative c3. We can make those positive, so that looks a little nicer for us. Now we're going to look at our cosine of 2t terms. And we get 2c3 equals negative c2 plus 1. There's a 1 right there, right? Cosine. All right, now we have to substitute in. We see that c3 equals 2c2, so we can have 4c2 equals negative c2 plus 1. So we get 5c2 equals 1, which means c2 equals 1/5. We go back up, and we solve, and we see that C3 equals 2/5. Alright, we're going to have to create some space, but basically what we're seeing now is that we have y equals the C1 e to the negative t plus 1/5 cosine of 2t plus 2/5 sine of 2t. But we have to now consider our initial value. So we substitute, and I'm just going to do, this is when we're using our initial conditions. And we see that y at 0 equals 5, so we have 5 equals c1 e to the 0, right? And so that's just going to leave c1, because e to the 0 equals 1, so we have it multiplied by 1, plus 1/5 times the cosine at 0 is also 1, plus 2/5. The sine at 0 is 0, so this goes away. This turns into just 0. So we have 5 equals c1 plus 1 fifth, and we subtract over, and we see that this is going to be 4 and 4 fifths, or another way of looking at that is 24 fifths. Now we're just going to get our explicit solution. I'm sorry, this is kind of roundabout, but this is equal to C1. So I'm just going to box your final solution. Your final solution should be 24 fifths times e to the negative t plus 1 fifth cosine of 2t plus 2 fifths.